Come on, man.
Is he tight?
Right here, dude. No, I didn't do it. Did you get the one in the back?
No.
Dude, tell me it looks stupid.
Why didn't you do that one?
Because I got the one in the front. So you got one of those two.
There's not one back there.
You should not know.
Now you're ready to go up.
Clap when cool stuff happens.
Nah, I'm too busy filming. It's too good for us to go after. So what kind of parts do you have here, Darren? This is a truck.
This is the truck.
This is a truck.
Yep. Hold on one second. Let me get this car finished up. You
want to throw some?
No, I'm going to just put these out. Go down so they're ready. Mm-hmm. So this is a truck. It's a three-piece system. Truck sides, bolster, we got a jig that you can set the bolster in. You can lift these up and they're interlocked in here. You lift them up so where this part here is above that and they just slide right off. Both sides do that, take springs out. So then you can tear it down into three big sets. You got the wheel sets. This is for the brake system, brake beams, brake levers. These are constant contact sides. That's for the car to rock. If you want cars to rock, these prevent them from tipping over. There is measurements that you gotta go by to keep it the right alignment.
So each part of the system here, we've got the car number on it.
Yep, and that's just in case a big derailment. Whatever, where the truck sets come up from the car, you'll be able to tell which truck set the car go, or
right.
What truck set the car belongs to. They're numbered here too, which means going from the B end, you got number one axle, number two axle, three axle, four axle. Going from the B end, you got the right side, left side. That, like I said, that's just in case a derailment or something happens. Where the truck sets come off the car, we're able to tell what direction the truck set goes and what location it goes to.
Cool. And the B end is the end with the brake on.
Yep, B end's the end with the brake.
Cool. Other questions?
All right, I'll have you guys back up just a little bit. You can stand right in front of the shed, it'd be a good place. We're gonna have the forklift coming in and out of here. Scrubs, you want to grab that?
That wedge?
So what's that yellow disc that you put in your meat out of?
It's like a hard plastic.
Okay.
The shim.
I took the one out. The one that was in it is metallic. And this is a 100 ton car. So they can't be metallic in them. They got to be a non-metallic.
Okay.
The reason is the car's too heavy. So it'll make the shim bolt, and it'll cause truck issues. So that's why I like changed it out.
Is it better in there?
Huh? It was good when you had it.
No.
Might throw it down.
You gonna let one of these guys put it down?
$2, man.
Ready?
Change two wheels.
That's how easy it is to change wheels.